Everyone, and welcome to the Fasman Yeshiva High School open house. My name is Rabbi Dovid Kupchik. I'm the Menahel, principal here at the Yeshiva. And I want to welcome parents and Talmidim from near and far, from here in Chicagoland to all over the United States and Canada. So, so happy to have each and every one of you. I hope everyone is doing well. I hope everyone is safe and healthy. And we say here in the wintertime in Chicago, and warm. And typically we would be having these types of programs in person. And I truly miss having that human interaction. But I do look forward when mitzvah Hashem, things will be hopefully back to normal and we'll be able to get together. But for now, I really hope that you will enjoy tonight's 1 hour long program that we have planned for you. So you get a great feel and taste of the Yeshiva. A schedule of our program this evening it can be found on our chat. Feel free to access it. I am thrilled to welcome to our program this evening our Rosh HaYeshiva, Rabbi Avraham Friedman. You'll hear from him shortly. Rabbi Shmuel Schumann, our CEO, who's so dedicated to our entire Yeshiva and campus. To Mr. Brian Levinson, our co-president of our board. And I'm going to give you a little bit of a taste of a feel for our Yeshiva. You know, this is a very exciting time for you as parents, for you as Talmidim. At the same time, it could be an anxious time. It's a combination. I truly hope you are enjoying eighth grade. I truly hope you've enjoyed 8 years of great elementary school education. And a part of you doesn't want to quickly leave. At the same time, looking forward to that next exciting stage in life, to a place that hopefully is going to include serious Torah learning, great education, preparation for life. So one question that we are so proud of here at the Yeshiva is a question that comes from so many Rosh Yeshiva and Rebbeim in Eretz Yisrael, and that is, how do you do it? Why do we feel that here in Eretz Yisrael, we all want the Skokie guys? We all want the Yeshiva guys. What's that secret? And I'll tell you, it has to do with the fact what our goal is. Our goal here at the Yeshiva is to educate and produce the complete Ben Torah, the well-rounded, well-balanced, what we call the full package. First and foremost, the Yeshiva is about a serious place of Torah learning. The environment from the get-go, the moment they arrive in the morning, they arrive to a base medrash, to a gorgeous base medrash, to an inviting base medrash. We have a program that you're going to hear about that includes caring Rebbeim, well-trained Rebbeim, Rebbeim who know how to reach your son and reach you. We have different levels of shiurim that you will hear about. Next, in addition to our learning program that is, of course, what guides us and leads us, is a rigorous general studies program, one that we refer to as college preparatory, one that prepares you for that next step after high school, after Beis Medrash, to be ready to receive the education that's going to prepare you for a profession, for a parnasa. We have an array of extracurricular and co-curricular activities that brings out the innate talents and interests of our wide range of Talmidim. Everyone has a different interest, and that's why we have so many different activities to tap into. It's not only about getting a serious Torah education and rigorous general studies education, but it's also tapping into the human side of who each Talmid is. We have a very warm, caring environment. We have great ruach. Our Yeshiva guys are known all over the world for that tremendous ruach that's heard all over, and that there's such great pride that guys have belonging to the yeshiva. So it's a complete package that we offer here. And it doesn't happen overnight. It doesn't happen in one day. It happens in 4 years. But after 4 years, it comes together to be a truly enriching individual, an enriched graduate of our yeshiva. That is our secret. We have high goals. We have a tall order. And we do it all in the environment. There is one guiding theme that leads us. We say the bracha each and every day, lasso bedivrei Torah. Why specifically that word? Because we shouldn't just be busy with our learning. Be busy with the whole experience. We experience Torah. We experience a Jewish life. We experience a Yiddish life. We experience our education. It's hands-on. It comes to life. And hopefully you will hear so many examples in this evening's program of how it comes to life. I want to therefore ask you to enjoy tonight's program, take notes in the program, be in touch with us. We will be giving you information throughout the evening how you could continue learning about our yeshiva. Our yeshiva is on a great, great trajectory. We have exciting programs and projects coming up with improving our facilities, building and remodeling our classrooms for our state-of-the-art 21st century classrooms. We have an athletic facility that is in the making. So, Bli Ayin Hara, we have so much going on here at the yeshiva. I want you to enjoy this evening. It gives me great kavod and honor to now introduce and give the floor over to Rabbi Avraham Friedman, our Rosh Yeshiva, who interacts with our Talmidim, who knows this yeshiva, who loves this yeshiva through and throughout. So please, for a short Dvar Torah, Rabbi Friedman, thank you.
Thank you very much, Rabbi Kupchik, and thank you all the parents and Talmidim that are here tonight. I think this is the first time, of course, in our history that we have the virtual open house. It's a history of high school is over 60 years. Yeshiva is about 100 years old. The first time that we have a virtual open house. And it's been an amazing year. I mean, we could say Shechiyonu v'kimonu v'giyonu l'zman hazeh. It's really amazing that I see every day when I see the boys come and I see a lot of smiling people. I don't see the smiling faces because they have masks, but I see the smiling eyes. They come into the Beis Medrash, come all over the building. We have many tefillahs today. We can't be in one room. Can't be more than 50 people in one room. So we have three places that they daven in the morning. And I see them, and I see the simcha, because the boys know that they're growing. They're growing in the Yerushalayim, growing in Torah, Abbas HaTorah. And it's amazing that we have to thank those who also in the yeshiva who help protect us, the CEO, the principal, all those who are capable and doing this for us, making sure that we're all safe and that we have all the rules kept and the social distancing. And everybody knows it's not easy in these days. But it's amazing, amazing yeshiva. I've been around for a long time. As Rabbi Kupchik said, I came to this yeshiva over 60 years ago. I came to the yeshiva. I also came in the yeshiva and as a young boy into the high school. And I saw many, many years, I saw the Talmidim grow in many, many places. They've gone all over the world. Our Talmidim have grown and they become famous in many different areas, whether it's in Rabbonis and in Dayonis and in business, in whatever, in the professions. Our Talmidim is amazing. They have a tremendous name. And a tremendous ruach has been created in our yeshiva. What is this ruach of the yeshiva? There's many yeshivas today. Baruch Hashem in Chicago alone, there's many yeshivas and good yeshivas. But we say, kina sofim tar b'chochma. The more there is, the better we have to be. And we keep working at it. And the yeshiva Baruch Hashem, every year I see, we improve in so many areas. So many things that we do, we can see, we make it. Make it happen, make it work. I want to say two things that two points I want to say, and one with a Dvar Torah explaining a little bit more why I think this yeshiva is very unique. Yeshiva is unique in two ways, I think. First of all, besides being a wonderful yeshiva high school, as you see, we have all the boys graduate, and they almost all, 90% or more, go to Eretz Israel and learn and shteig. We have also Baruch Hashem of Beis Medrash, We have wonderful Rabbeim at the Beis Medrash, great Talmid Chachomim. We have a Poisek in the Beis Medrash, and he teaches Yoredeya and Smicha, so the boys can see also some learning that they see a Hemshech. It's not just you go in high school. You're going to know, I want to be Mamshech by learning. So they want to see that. They want to see what it means to be on a higher level. And they can see that people can get Smicha, and people can go on and become Rabbonim and Dayanim and other things. They go to Eretz Yisrael and Yishtag and become the best Bachrim in all the yeshivas. When I went to the Mir Yeshiva, Rav Nochum Pertsamas used to say, the best Bachrim come from Skokie Yeshiva. And that was then, and that's now. You have to know it because we have tremendous, Baruch Hashem, tremendous Rabbeim with Mesiras Nefesh, and they teach on a high level. That's the first thing I think that we have to realize. We have also, Baruch Hashem, a nice koilo in the afternoon. We have Mechanchim, we have Rabbeim who learn in our koilo. It was a very, very high level koilo. Baruch Hashem, they can see that ruach which Rabbi Kupchik said we have in our yeshiva. It's a ruach built on Torah. A day they can come into yeshiva and see Torah. One more nakuda I want to think is unique to our yeshiva. Something which is unique to our yeshiva, and all the yeshivas in town and around the country are great. But I think there's something very unique about our yeshiva, and that is something, you know, I think we're built on the model of Slabodka. Our first Rebbeim, the founders of our yeshiva were Slabodka Rebbeim. I believe that we're built on that shita, because we find in the Torah very interesting. And we look at all the parashas in Bereishis, we're reading Sefer Bereishis, and we find a very unique thing. Because we know that the Ovis, of course, it says in the Gemara that the Ovis, each one had a yeshiva. Each one was born a yeshiva to the Asmo. Avraham Yitzchak Yaakov had Talmidim. And they had a yeshiva. But it seems very interesting that we find that in Vayetze, when Yaakov left, he was going away from his house. He was going to Lovan. He said he went and spent 14 years in the yeshiva of Aver, Sheba Aver. Why would he go to another yeshiva? He already learned in the yeshiva. He learned by his father. He had a good Rebbe. He learned till 15. He learned by Avraham Avinu. Then he learned till 63. He was 63 years old. 63 is kind of old even for a yoga man. And wherever you are, it's not so young. He went 14 more years to learn in the yeshiva, Shem Be'aver. It's very interesting. Why do you have to go to another yeshiva, Shem Be'aver? And then it says also, Ben Skunim Hulo. It says in Vayeshev, this week's Parsha, Ben Skunim Hulo, that Yosef, his father said that this is his son, Ben Skunim. Rashi brings from the Unklis. He says, Ben Skunim means a Bar Chochem. Bar Chochem, he was the one who taught him the Torah. He taught him the Torah. And Rashi brings, what Torah did he teach him? What special Torah was taught? The Torah that he taught, it says, that Yaakovino taught, was teaching over to his son, to Yosef, was the Torah of Shem Be'aver. So it's interesting, why we dafka Shem Be'aver? It's a fine yeshiva. They had a good yeshiva. I'm sure that Yitzchak had a nice yeshiva. Avram had a nice yeshiva. But why was it necessary also to go out when he's leaving now the house? Yaakovino is going to Lavan. He has to dafka go to a new yeshiva, the Shem Be'aver. What did he need to get smicha over there? Why did he need that? And why dafka, when it says in the Parsha, when they were fighting King Ben's Kunim, it says also in the Parsha, that the sons were fighting to get out. It says Esav and Yaakov wanted to go out. And where were they going? So one was going to Beis Avodah Zorah, and the other one was running to the yeshiva, to Shem Be'aver. Why are they going to Shem Be'aver? Why dafka that yeshiva? So Rabbi Yaakov Kamenetsky says a beautiful board. His grandson was a Rebbe in our yeshiva for many years. And he said the beautiful board. He says, because the yeshiva of Shem Be'aver was not just like the yeshiva of Avraham Yitzchak Yaakov. They taught Torah. They taught, they learned, it says the Abbas Merkaim Kol HaTorah Kula. But Shem Be'aver was teaching about the ways of the world. Shem Be'aver taught him what's out there. If you want to go out into the world, you're going into a Lovan, you're going to places where it's not so easy to be a Ben Torah. It's not so easy when you go into business to be a Ben Torah, to be a Yosher, to go into a show and to be an honest doctor, a Frum doctor, to be a Frum Rav is not easy also, to be an Erlach. And that's what our yeshiva teaches, how you do it in the world, not only in the Svarim, to become a great Talmud Chacham. The Rebbeim teach you how to learn a Gemara, but they teach you how to live in the world also. In all those places, Shem Be'aver, look at all those places in the Torah where it mentions that they went to Shem Be'aver. Dafka, they went out to see what's going to be in the world. Yaakov Avinu, Beisrutsu Aboni Bekirba, they were learning the Torah. The Malach taught him Kol HaTorah Kula. It says in the Gemara that a Malach teaches everybody a Kol HaTorah Kula. But when he left the mother, it says he wanted to run outside. He wanted to see what's in the world. He needed to go to Shem Be'aver. That's our yeshiva. Our yeshiva is Slabodke. Our yeshiva has the learning inside and the learning for the outside. That I think is unique about our yeshiva.
Yashar Koyach. Thank you. Thank you so much, Rabbi Friedman. And spot on, as they say, Yashar Koyach Gadol. At this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our student president. Would like to share a few words of his perspective as a student, as a Talmud in the yeshiva, Tzvi Abrams. Tzvi.
Thank you, Rabbi Kupchik. My name is Tzvi Abrams, and I'm a 12th grader here at Fasman Yeshiva High School. I am, like Rabbi Kupchik said, I am the student body president. Fasman Yeshiva High School offers a phenomenal education in Limudei Kodesh. Each grade has numerous shiurim so that your son is placed in the ideal learning environment that will make him thrive. Each Rebbe creates a warm kesher with each individual Talmud and instills a love of learning. I have seen firsthand how they really go out of their way to care for every single kid in the shiur. Just as recently as this week, my 11th grade Rebbe called in to check on me knowing that I just tested positive. Not only did he call Sunday night, but he called last night, and he just recently called a couple hours ago just to make sure I was holding up. Each Rebbe really cares for every individual Talmud. I had Rabbi Zimmerman as my freshman Rebbe. I had Rabbi Haskell as my sophomore Rebbe. I had Rabbi Weiss as my junior Rebbe. And now I have currently Rabbi Siegel. Going through the yeshiva with four excellent Rebbeim really taught me a variety of skills, and I look forward to using them in my future years of learning. The graduates from Fasman Yeshiva are known to be the top Talmidim in various yeshivas in Israel, and it is no surprise that yeshiva graduates get into all the top yeshivas due to the amazing Limudei Kodesh that the yeshiva provides us. I now have the pleasure of introducing our three phenomenal freshmen Rebbeim to discuss the Limudei Kodesh program further, Rabbi Zimmerman, Rabbi Goldman, and Rabbi Cardash.
Okay, hi everyone. It's so nice to see you. You all look amazing, all look great. The screens with the little names on them is just absolutely amazing. My name is Tzvi Zimmerman. I teach the ninth grade for those who are in the higher level ninth grade. My plan is to be able to make every boy become the Talmud Chacham that I absolutely know that they should be. We have a very rigorous schedule, and it has quite a bit to it. We learn well over 15 blocks, Gemara, Rashi, Tosfos, and Ikari Shonim during the first year. It takes a little bit to get up there. But right now, we're already on the Rif. We learned Aran earlier today. That's the type of sugyas that we're trying to get to so that they get to Rishonim through their ninth grade year. Mishnah Berurah, by the end of the year, your son will know how to read through a Mishnah Berurah. But not only that, he'll know what the Mishnah Berurah is. Why do we learn Mishnah Berurah? What is the Mishnah Berurah and the Sharat Zion and the Bir Halacha? They're quizzed about this daily. They know how to be able to go through, and with a little word given to them here and there, they can read it through completely. When it comes to Chumash, they're going to know how to read a Rashi. The point behind my shir is that at the end of the year, they will know how to read a Rashi properly, know what questions to ask on a Rashi. How does Rashi work? The question that he asks and then answers afterward. And then Navi. We've already finished in my shir so far, Yoshua and Shoftim, and they know it. You can ask them, and Yoshua and Shoftim. We plan to learn Shmuel, Shmuel, Beis, and Malachim. It's a schedule that allows for these boys to gain so much. Aside from Bikias, we do an entire parak of Gemara afterward. It's supposed to be something that your child, your son, is going to gain from and become somebody who you know already how great he is. He's going to get better and better and better. And it's my pleasure to be a part of that. And for all the Rebbeim of Skokie, you should be a part of that. Thank you so much, everyone. Have a great night.
Thank you so much, Rabbi Zimmerman. Rabbi Goldman. Unmute.
Hey, thank you, Rabbi Kupchik. Sorry about that. So as Rabbi Zimmerman said, it's good to see everyone. I never get used to this, really just talking straight to myself. That's all I see right on the screen here, but I'm assuming everyone looks good and everyone's enjoying the night so far. So I want to really pick up on something Rabbi Kupchik mentioned, Rabbi Friedman mentioned about it also. So one of the key things I think really highlights Skokie Yeshiva is that we really do take a holistic approach. We really address the entirety of the bachur. In my role as a ninth grade Rebbe, I get to see all the freshmen coming in and to see how they start as freshmen in high school. But I'm also one of the Mashgichim along with Rabbi Zimmerman, and I'm also the guidance counselor. So in that role, I really get to see how the yeshiva addresses every single Talmud on all different levels. That we don't just put them in a desk, throw a Gemara at them, and expect you're going to develop into a Talmud Chacham and a Tzadik. You know, the teenage years, they need involvement. They need to be developed. They need to be dealt with, to be spoken to be taught, not just the Sfarim in front of them, but about life, Hashkafas HaChayim. We taught about how to live life, how to handle complicated situations that come up. And we really try to develop all of these skills within each Talmud from a holistic approach, that we help them learn, we help them grow as B'nai Torah. We also view the emotional side, and we make sure they're being taken care of. We view the social side of things, and make sure that they have a chevra, they have friends, they're developing properly, they're involved in Gemilas Chasodim, so they're out there in the world and developing that side of themselves, and not just hold up in a corner. We really do take that holistic approach, so that by we bring in these freshmen as ninth graders into our yeshiva, into our shiurim, and by the time they get to seniors, and as it's mentioned so many times already, they go off to Eretz Yisrael to yeshivas, and they're shining bachurim that all the yeshivas want. Baruch Hashem, we've seen so much hatzlacha in taking this holistic approach. Yirtzeh Hashem, hoping to do so with your sons as well. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Thank you so much, Rabbi Goldman. Rabbi Cardash, thank you for joining us.
Good evening. My name is Rabbi Aaron Cardash. I myself am a graduate of Fasman Yeshiva High School. I'm fortunate with Siyata Deshmaya that this is my 29th year of teaching ninth grade. My goal as a Rebbe is to teach Torah specifically by building their skills in order for each Talmud to grow in his learning and be able to be an independent learner. I firmly believe that a successful student is a student that demonstrates proficiency and autonomy to do the task that is required to do. Some of the skills that I'm focused on are deconing Gemara skills, how to navigate through Gemara, note-taking skills and study skills, and midos, interpersonal relationship skills. It's with these skills that a student can grow and be very successful. Emir Tzasham, I'm looking forward to meet each and every one of you in person. Thank you for listening. Have a good night.
Yeshikoa, thank you so much, Rabbi Cardash. At this time, we have prepared, Tzvi Abrams in particular, has prepared to take you on a brief tour of a typical day that he's been experiencing lately at the yeshiva. Keep in mind that this is a pandemic and that we are thrilled that we, Baruch Hashem, are open for business. But afternoon schedule is a little bit different than typical, but it gives you a little bit of a taste. At the right time, we are gonna schedule some in live time, an opportunity for parents during a typical morning to be able to visit our yeshiva. And also on a day when many Talmidim will have a day off, we'll invite Talmidim, eighth graders, to also visit and get a taste of what the yeshiva is like. But for now, here we go. Thank you, Tzvi, for putting together a short video presentation.
Good morning. My name is Tzvi Abrams, and I'm a senior here at Fasman Yeshiva High School, ready to go for an amazing day packed with Torah learning and general studies. I got to be in my car at 7:30 to get to the yeshiva at 7:45 for davening. Let me take you along. Let's go. I have arrived at the yeshiva. Every single day, we are required to fill out a COVID questionnaire to make sure, you know, that we're staying away from COVID and that in case someone does have it, chas v'shalom, doesn't spread here at the yeshiva. Very safe place here. So every single morning we fill it out. You know, we talk to our security guard to make sure he knows who everyone is. Due to COVID, we have three different minyanim here at the yeshiva. We have a senior minyan with the Beis Medrash and the Rosh Yeshiva, Rabbi Friedman. We have a junior minyan, and we have a freshman and a sophomore minyan. In previous years, there's also been a Sephardi minyan. So here at the yeshiva, there's a lot of different minyanim to choose from. It is almost time for davening. I'm gonna go into davening right now, and next time you'll see me, we will be getting breakfast. Let's go. Morso, open the door with the key card. Thank you so much. And yeah, this is the time where we all have breakfast in our lunchroom, Fornishai. And yeah.
For breakfast every morning, hand sanitizer. Today's breakfast, hash browns. Morning, we go. Thank you. Had our breakfast, let's go.
Okay, we just finished breakfast. Ellie, show your face.
Hi.
There it is.
Can I take my mask?
No, mask on always. So we're gonna walk into Halacha Seder now, and I'll see you guys after Gabar at break.
I feel this to you.
Here at the Yeshiva, we have a senior-run canteen run by Gabi Warsaw. And, you know, during break, the guys, you know, chill here. We give them food, obviously very safe with the gloves. Let me see the gloves, Warsaw. Got the gloves. All types of food, as you see. You got candy, you got, you know, pretzels. We sell sushi. We got drinks. Everything you could like. So just after an amazing meal at the Yeshiva, if you're still hungry, there's always different alternatives for food. Okay, so we just finished break, and during break, usually what I do is I have a presidential meeting with my co-president, Solomon Dovid, from Houston, Texas. Very happy that the dormers were allowed to come back so I could, you know, talk about various merch we're going to sell, how we can improve the Yeshiva. So I'm going to have a meeting with him, and we'll talk soon. Okay, so I just finished up my presidential meeting with Solomon. A lot of good ideas that we're brainstorming, how to make the Yeshiva more fun and a better place for everyone. And now I'm walking into the second half of Shir. We're going to be going over the Gemara that we learned. And hopefully after that, I have lunch and I'll talk to you guys then. So I just finished second Seder. Now I'm about to get into my car and go home for some English Zoom classes. Here we are, first Zoom class of the day, Mr. Passman's second period writer's workshop class. So I just finished my second period class with Mr. Passman, had a good discussion about grammar. Heading to third period, I have a base medrash period with Ruby Kupchik at Yeshurun. So I'm getting into my car right now, and I will see you guys soon at Yeshurun. Okay, third period, base medrash period here at Yeshurun. I'm learning Mishnah Berurah with my chavrusa, Ruby Kupchik. And yeah, we write a paper each week on what we learned the previous week to show Rabbi Cancer. Okay, my base medrash period is over. Heading back into my car to drive back to my house for some fourth period law by Mr. Verdaguer. Very, very good teacher. I've had him for 3 years and looking forward to law today.
Criminals try to do, okay? Although some people believe that anti-spam laws violate free speech rights, spammers have been prosecuted by them.
This is my fifth period Jewish history class led by Rabbi Weiber. It's a senior only class, very interesting. Talk about the Holocaust and other various aspects of Jewish life. It is approximately 5:15 right now. I just got out of Jewish history. Now it's sixth period. I have free period now. So what I do during free period, now that I'm home, you know, I'll do some homework, call some friends who also have sixth period free. You know, if I was at the Yeshiva, maybe I'll go to the canteen, go to the student lounge. Today, I have a Jewish history assignment I'm going to work on. So that's going to be during sixth period. Then at about 6, I'm going to go have dinner. And next time you'll see me, I'll be getting into my car driving to Ohel Tfila, where the seniors have night seder with Rabbi Rebbach. So I'll see you guys at night seder. Okay, I'm in my car wearing my yeshiva sweatshirt. It is currently 6:58. We have night seder 7:10 at Ohel Tfila in West Artist Park on Tui. Okay, just made it to Ohel Tfila. We have night seder from 7:10 to 8 o'clock. Then we have Marv after, and the day is over. So let me bring you along to Night Seder. Okay, here we are at Night Seder. Here's Daniel Backrack, another fellow senior. And, you know, we're here at Ohel Tzvila for Night Seder. Hour of learning, and then Marv, let's go. Okay, so I'm back at home now after a long day at the Yeshiva. You know, one of the good things about the Yeshiva is after a long day, you really feel accomplished. That, you know, you had a great day of morning Seder, great English education, and a great night seder. So thank you guys for watching A Day in the Life, and excited to see more Yeshiva stuff soon.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed being able to get a taste of a day at the Yeshiva. At this time, we are going to be moving along in our schedule and our program for this evening. And I'd like to introduce our Associate Principal of General Studies, Mr. Peter Gobel, who will introduce our General Studies program. And then you'll have an opportunity as well to hear from another student and department chairheads as well. All right, Mr. Gobel, thank you for joining us.
Hello, thank you, Rabbi Kupchik. Hello, parents, colleagues, students, welcome. Thanks for being here tonight. As I'm looking through the gallery, I see some familiar last names and faces on the screen, and I see some new ones as well, which is wonderful. That video from Tzvi Abrams is going to be really a tough act to follow, but I will try. That was really awesome. My name is Mr. Peter Gobel. As Rabbi Kupchik said, I'm the Associate Principal of General Studies here at Rabbi Oscar Z. Fasman Yeshiva College Preparatory High School. A lot of people here have already mentioned that they have been here for a long time, and it's safe to say that you'll hear more people mention that before the night is done. Baruch Hashem, it's my 10th year at Fasman Yeshiva, and it's in my 8th year in this role as General Studies Principal. It's amazing how much positive change and growth I've been able to witness over the time that I've spent here. As Rabbi Kupchik said at the beginning of this evening, as high school administrators, we are really ultimately looking to build well-rounded Talmidim at Fasman Yeshiva. Rabbi Zimmerman mentioned that we have a very long day. You saw it in Svi's video, that we ask our students to work hard and to study hard and to hold themselves to a very high standard. And you've already heard a bit about Yeshiva's Limudei Kodesh, our Judaic studies offerings. Later, you're going to hear more about our activities, extracurriculars, dorm life, the application process. Right now, in the next portion of this evening's program, you're going to get to hear a little bit more about our Limudei Kol, our general studies classes. As a general studies staff, we work very hard to take a very individual approach to working with each of our students. Our goal is to push each student as far forward as we possibly can in the time that we get to spend with them. And all the time, we work with an understanding that that means something different for each kid in each class. As a staff, we're really able to offer a wide variety of coursework at multiple academic levels with small class sizes and great student to teacher ratios. And just like students build a great rapport, the teachers get to know our students personally and vice versa. Our students can really make the most out of their high school experience with an academic schedule that's appropriately challenging to them as an individual. As Rabbi Kupchik also mentioned, we've taken huge leaps and bounds this school year alone in outfitting our classrooms with state-of-the-art teaching and learning technology, which allows our staff to teach in person, remotely, or in hybrid mix. And if you're paying close attention, you saw some of that technology was in action during Tzvi Abrams' video. There's also some really great things coming in the coming years. We value our students being informed and civically minded. Our students complete independent study work online. In 10th grade, our students study civics and the state and U.S. constitutions. In 9th and 11th grades, our students look into student current world events and have individual discussions, group discussions on these things. In the coming school year, hopefully in a post-COVID world, we're looking to add a service learning component in 9th and 11th grade as well. When our students do need extra academic support or accommodations, in most cases, we're able to provide them. Rabbi Jeremy Hartstein and Rabbi Aharon Gutstein manage special services and student academic accommodations. They act as conduits for communication with everyone involved when students are having a hard time academically and they need some extra help. As part of our general studies program, we offer homework academy and tutoring in the evenings after school or after night seder, also by appointment during free periods. There are teachers and tutors who can offer homework and study help in science, math, English, social studies, and even just general studies skills and organization. The two words in our very long formal title, college preparatory, are also very important, and I want to touch on that as well. While we are pushing our students to be successful in their general studies coursework while they're with us, we are also striving to prepare them for life after high school. And in that effort, we offer some dynamic and different elective courses that students might not be able to find at other high schools. We offer electives in computer applications, physiology, health and wellness, economics, law, consumer education, and our very, very popular STEM classes, Introduction to Scientific Engineering and Principles of Scientific Engineering. Fasman Yeshiva also offers 7 to 8 advanced placement classes every school year, and we facilitate self-study students taking another 4 or 5 additional AP tests as well. In partnership with HTC, we have 12th graders are able to take dual enrollment classes, earning college credit before graduation. We offer our students college admissions testing on campus in the form of the ACT plus writing. Our 11th graders get standardized testing preparation as part of their course schedule. We offer students one-on-one assistance and career and college guidance in choosing both Israeli yeshiva and American colleges and universities. But don't just take my word for it. In the next few minutes, you're going to get to hear from one of our 11th grade students. And albeit briefly, you're also going to get to hear from 4 veteran general studies teachers. They are each respectively department chairman or co-department chairman. They each represent one of the 4 major general studies content areas: English, social studies, science, math. And they all happen to teach 9th grade as well. So they may very well have your son as a student next year. So with that, I thank you one more time and I turn it over. Thank you, Rabbi Kupchik. Thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you so much, Mr. Gobel, and it gives me great honor to introduce Avidon Garfinkel, an 11th grade Talmud at Yeshiva, who will speak briefly about his education in the General Studies Department.
Thank you, Rabbi Kupchik and Mr. Gobel for introducing me. Hi, my name is Avidon Garfinkel. I'm in 11th grade and I'm from Chicago, Illinois. The English department of the Yeshiva is extremely flexible in regards to the student's strengths and weaknesses. For example, if you're an extremely strong math student, the Yeshiva offers a track called telescopic math that allows one to experience math at the highest levels. The same goes for reading, writing, science, and history. I would also like to add that the Yeshiva offers all different types of AP classes. For example, AP Bio, which I personally have had a fantastic experience with, AP US History, AP Comparative Government, AP Calculus, AP Literature, and other various APs. But even if you don't want to take APs, you can still be challenged at a rigorous level. I know a lot of people that are still being challenged at the highest of level. The most impressive thing about the English Department of the Yeshiva has to be its ability to offer form-fitting classes to all of its students. I feel that the Yeshiva has challenged me in both English and Limudei Kodesh and has prepared me for the next level of education, which is college. And lastly, it would be my honor to present our department chairs, Mr. Lindner from our English department, Mr. Verdaguer from our history department, Mr. Gabrail from our science department, and Mr. Hayes from our math department. Have a good night.
I guess I'm up.
Mr. Lindner, thank you so much. You are up.
Thank you. Am I unmuted? Okay.
You're on.
Great. Welcome, and this is my 8th year at the Yeshiva. I am Michael Lindner. This is my 43rd year in education, and I'm the department chair for the English department. In the English department, we offer 4 years of English studies for freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors. It's a 4-year program which satisfies the state requirements for the English requirements for the state. We also offer a telescopic English course. That's by department invitation only, and that course is reserved for students who show a special interest in English or a special talent in English. In the 11th and 12th grade, we offer writer's workshop for those students who would feel that they need to pursue that instead of the regular junior and senior English program, and we do offer advanced placement courses. We do writing on a daily basis, both formal and informal. We study paragraph types and essay formats. We develop research papers and MLA formatting. We create short stories, plays, and poetries. We review grammatical structures and editing procedures. And we do college composition and entry essay work for our juniors and seniors who are at that stage where they need to develop that for their college placement. Writing is extremely important in our department, and we do it on a daily basis. We also have a heavy emphasis on reading. We read in all genres, novels, plays, short stories, poetry, and nonfiction. So it's a very well-balanced program with lots of opportunities for students to make choices. And I think that your son would do very well to be a part of our English department. Thank you. I hope to get to meet some of you in person next year. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Lindner, Mr. Verdaguer, representing our history department. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. My name is Mr. Verdaguer, and I'm the social studies co-chair and West Civ teacher here at the Yeshiva. I've been teaching here for about 8 years. I enjoy teaching at the Yeshiva for many reasons, but the most important reason is the students' love for learning, and I think that was echoed today. As a teacher, you can really see the quality and care in their work. Right now, I'd like to speak now about the social studies curriculum. Ninth graders will start their high school education with West Civ and current events. Here, they will adapt to the difference between grade school history and high school history. This includes learning skills like critical thinking, summarizing, essay writing, and so on. We also work on projects with the English classes with Mr. Lindner, and this includes research and writing some imaginative stuff, like writing alternative history. In 10th grade, they will be taking US history and civics. Here, their learning matures into more analysis of primary source documents and longer research projects. And then finally, during their upperclassmen years, they will take Jewish history, participate in the successful Names Not Numbers program, and other AP classes that include AP US History, AP Gov, and others more on a rotating basis. These are all college-rated courses where students will earn college credit and will further cultivate their talents into higher education. Thank you so much for coming today.
Thank you so much, Mr. Verdaguer. Just want to give a shout out to our Names and Numbers project. We have the most amount of hits of any Yeshiva high school across our country, over 3,000 hits. So we're so proud of that documentary that our last year's seniors put together. All right, Mr. Gabrail, happy to have you this evening to represent our science department. You're on. Well, let's unmute yourself. Okay, let's see. Could just unmute, I think we'll be ready. Okay. We are going to get back to Mr. Gabrail, who is just experiencing a minor technicality. There's a tip of advice to use the admin to unmute him. I think our tech team, we're gonna go to Mr. Hayes. Mr. Hayes, do we hear you?
Yes, I hope.
Yes.
Very good. Thank you. My name is Brian Hayes. I'm the chairman of the math department. I've been teaching at the Yeshiva for 24 years, and it's my pleasure to come back every year because how hard the students work. It's very fulfilling as a teacher to work with hardworking students, and I've been seeing them for 24 years here at school. At the Yeshiva, we have three levels of math through all the years of math, so that no matter where your son is in terms of ability, we have a program for him. If your son is a little on the weaker side, we can help with that. If you have a good math student, we've got something for you. If you have an excellent math student, that's the telescopic program that you've heard about a couple times already tonight. I'm the teacher of the telescopic ninth grade class, and those students who stay in the telescopic group wind up taking calculus, AP calculus in senior year, and they actually start learning calculus in the second half of junior year. Before class begins freshman year, the students take a placement test, the placement test to make sure we get them placed where they have something to learn and will succeed. And as the time progresses, adjustments are made. If adjustments are necessary, we want to make sure the students stay at the right level, and we help them along the way. There's Homework Academy. I'm in charge of math homework academies, a couple evenings a week. There's many opportunities for help. And one more thing I definitely want to mention, Mr. Goble mentioned it. I think it's a very important point. The class sizes at the Yeshiva are wonderfully small. Average class size overall is 10 students or fewer. Very good for the students, very fulfilling for the teachers, just good for everybody. There's so many good things at the Yeshiva, and I hope everyone has a good evening and makes an excellent choice about your son's future. Good night.
Thank you so much, Mr. Hayes. All our students.
Are we good?
And Mr. Gabrail, I think we're back live.
Thank you very much for coming. My name is Jacob Gabrail. I'm the Science Department Chair. I think this is my 10th or 11th year at Fasman. Time flies, can't keep track. So I teach biology, chemistry, anatomy, physics, health, a couple of the AP courses. And I just want to give you a little bit of insight to the philosophy of the science department in our classes. We believe that science is a logical tool. It is a way of thinking. So we try to get our students to think logically and to provide an argument for why it is that they take the course of action that they do, to collect evidence, to collect data, and then to come to a rational conclusion. So throughout their years at the Yeshiva, they have the opportunity to flex those muscles across a wide array of classes. Freshmen start off in biology with either conceptual or honors. And the second year, we give them chemistry, so they learn how molecules interact with each other, both conceptual and honors as well. From there, they branch off and they can start to choose a path, seeing which one they like the most. Mr. Gobel talked to you about science, tech, engineering, and mathematics. It's relatively new in the Yeshiva, where students get to work with circuitry and they make year-long projects to then eventually pitch to a board with kind of how to, you know, sell an idea or a project like so. 2 years worth of STEM. We also have physics, which teaches students about the fundamental forces of the universe, and which leads into AP physics, both calculus-based and non-calculus-based, which offers the potential to get college credit for those advanced placement classes. And they can also go into advanced placement for biology and chemistry. Once again, college level courses that really challenge and push those students to think. In the previous years, we've had a lot of success with students in our AP classes, scoring very well on those exams, and then getting not only good GPA points from those classes, but also college recognition. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you so much, Mr. Gabrail, and the entire staff from the General Studies Department. You've heard this evening so far about our Limudei Kodesh department from our General Studies Department. You've heard from a number of students. We have the privilege now to hear from a perspective from a parent who's also an alumnus, proud alumnus of the Yeshiva. Gives me great pleasure and my honor to call on Rabbi Michael Greenland, International Director of NCSY, who has joined us this evening. Thank you, Rabbi Greenland.
Thank you, Rabbi Kupchik. Pleasure to be with everybody. I appreciate having the chance, even as a current parent and parent of two alumni, to have the chance to be a participant in this open house. As Rabbi Kupchik mentioned, I'm an alumnus myself of Fasman Yeshiva High School, of Skokie Yeshiva, and I really have a tremendous amount of gratitude towards the foundation that the Yeshiva was able to build for me. I think really this Yeshiva is incredibly unique. As you've heard tonight, it provides an incredibly strong foundation in Limudei Kodesh, and also a fantastic path forward in general studies. I have two sons who graduated from the Yeshiva within the last few years. Both attended Shalvim. One's currently in Shalvim, and one is at Lander College for Men in New York. And they're both still in touch with Rebbeim from their high school years, and consider consider those Rebbeim to have been formative in their path and development as what I'd like to call budding Talmidei Chachamim, and that's really something that my wife Rifki and I have tremendous appreciation for the Yeshiva having established that. At the same time, they really have developed a solid foundation in general studies and have a dynamic with the general studies teachers, seeing Mr. Gabrail here tonight, Mr. Lindner here tonight, Mr. Verdaguer here tonight, and Mr. Hayes here tonight. Mr. Hayes joined the Yeshiva 2 years after I graduated, so I just missed him, but my boys had the chance to learn from him. And they really enjoyed these teachers and benefited from their classes greatly. So the Yeshiva has my endorsement for your high school boys, and I'd be happy to, anybody wants to reach out to me and ask any questions, I'd be happy to further elaborate. Happy to keep the program going. Rabbi Kupchik, back to you.
Okay, thank you so much, Rabbi Greenland. And I really have much continued nachas from your older boys and your current Talmud, your current son in the Yeshiva, and Mitzvah Shem Ken Yirbu. Okay, at this time, we have a great opportunity to what we'll call take a little bit of a commercial break and hear from some alumni and some current students who have something to share with you about the Yeshiva. We're going to start with Yonatan Gershman. He'll tell you a little bit about himself. Yonatan, great to have you.
Hi, good to be here. My name is Yonatan Gershman. I'm from Chicago. I went to the Yeshiva for 4 years. I graduated in 2017 and then went to Shalvim for 3 years in Eretz Yisrael. I think I was asked to just highlight a few of the points that I thought really made a special impact on me. And I thought when I was first asked the question, the first thing that came to mind immediately was the fact, actually a comment that one of my friends made on the last night at the Yeshiva, which was that as he was looking around, we were sitting around a bonfire, and he looked around and he said, "I don't know if I could say this about any other place, but I look around here and I'd be more than happy to sit next to anyone here at the lunch table and be easily strike up conversation with all these people who are sitting around me." And just that insight, I thought, stuck with me ever since I left, which was that the Yeshiva is a place where, even though we, again, my best friends leaving the Yeshiva, we went to four different yeshivas. I went to Shalvim. I had a friend who went to Hakotel, one who went to Beis Yisrael, and one who went to Tomo. So if anyone is aware of the differences of those places, I think it's pretty remarkable one single place could produce so many boys who can be friends and still go to different places, which really I thought was special. I guess with that, I'll say have a great night, everybody. And yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Yonatan. And next we're gonna hear from Shai Younger. Shai, why don't you tell everyone where you're coming from, and happy to have you.
Thank you, Rabbi. Hello, hi. My name is Shai Younger. Before I say anything, I just want to say how last week when Rabbi Zizek asked me if I could come join, I told my chavrusa, I said, I may miss a little bit of night seder next week. He asked me why. I told him I have this program doing. He said, what is it? I told him, oh, my high school's having an open house. And one of the rabbis asked if I could join. I told him, how can I not? I have so much akarsa tov and real love for this yeshiva and for all the people you met tonight. I didn't even realize all these teachers would be here, and I'm so excited to see them. I have so much akarsa tov. There's no way I could not have been here. So that's why I'm here. Let me just tell you a few things a little about me. I'm from Cincinnati. I went to the yeshiva for 4 years. I was there from 2014 to 2018 is when I graduated. I was a dormer there for all 4 years and I loved it. I had a tremendous time there, great experience. Afterwards, I went to study in yeshiva in Israel. I went to Keren Biavna, KBY. I was supposed to go there for 1 year. My parents graciously allowed me, Baruch Hashem, to go there for a second year. Thank God. And now I'm at YU, and I'm in the YU Honors Program studying pre-med currently. There are two things that I think parents of incoming students and students themselves really, I think, should be really excited about when it comes to the yeshiva. I think the yeshiva does a really, really good job preparing guys for yeshiva in Israel. I have friends who went to, who started out at all different levels of learning and who went to all different types of yeshivas across the spectrum, as Yonatan was just saying. I have friends from all over the place. And they really, yeshiva guys, you guys from the yeshiva do really well at all these yeshivas. I think the yeshiva prepares them well to tap into social circles from people across the country, people across from other countries. They're able to approach Rebbeim confidently, but also respectfully. They're able to, they're also like, they're looking to learn, they're looking to grow. They're really, they, and if you speak to Rebbeim in Israel, they'll tell you that the guys from Skokie are something special. The guy is really, really out there to grow and to elevate themselves. And it's really, I'm really impressed by all my friends that all the people I know that are graduates and have gone. The second thing that I think parents and guys should be really excited about the yeshiva is that they really instill, I should say develop is probably better, like a certain like love or like enthusiasm for Yiddishkeit and for really the community in general. The guys come out of the yeshiva with a response, like with a sense of like responsibility to give back, to be always looking to help others, looking to encourage others, looking to like, where can I do my part? Where can I fill my role? And it's really like they have a strong sense of identity, of Jewish identity. And that's something that's really, I think, is really impressive that you don't find amongst everyone. And I think that's really special about the yeshiva. Besides that, I think if Fred Zizek, I don't know if he has, but if he wants, he's more than welcome to give my information to anyone. I'm more than happy to speak to any parents or any guys. If you have any questions, concerns, or if you just wanna, I don't know, clarify anything, I'm more than happy to speak. Thank you guys so much for having me. This is so cool. I appreciate it.
Amazing, amazing. Shai, thank you so much. We're moving along here, trying to keep it moving, but really everyone's conversation is and comments are meaningful. Yoel Sin, a senior at the yeshiva. Yoel, tell us a little bit about yourself. You're on. Unmute yourself.
Hi, I'm Yoel Sin from Houston, Texas, and I've been dorming at the yeshiva since starting high school, and I'm currently in my senior year here. What I love most about the yeshiva is that no matter which level of both shir and hashkafa you're currently holding at, the yeshiva environment welcomes you in warmly, along with all the Rebbeim, to be growing at your own comfortable pace, which just allows for so much potential in all the Talmidim, and really, the sky's the limit. And with that, I'll sign off and I hope your son can take advantage of all that the yeshiva has to offer.
Thank you so much, Yoel. Avram Meltzer, great to have you, a junior at the yeshiva. Go ahead.
So hi, I'm Avram Meltzer. I'm a junior at the yeshiva. I've been dorming for the last 2 years. I was a transfer sophomore. So I'm from New Haven, Connecticut. I went to SCHA as a kid. And the two things that I really love about the yeshiva is the unique like culture and brotherhood that we have here and the connection that everyone has. I don't think you can find that anywhere else.
I love it. Avram Meltzer, we love having you. And up next, we have Yoni Horowitz. Yoni, good to see you. Good to have you. You're on.
Hi, my name is Yoni Horowitz, and I'm a sophomore right now. I'm in 10th grade. I'm from Chicago, so I don't have to dorm. I live here. And my favorite parts about the yeshiva is how amazing the Hebrew and the English classes are and the davenings. Really think it's uplifting and it's really great.
Thank you so much, Yoni. Continued hatzlacha. Itai Klug. Itai, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Great to have you. Hi, my name is Itai Klug. I am in 11th grade. I'm a junior, and I'm from Skokie, Illinois. And I actually went to Hill Torah growing up, and now I'm at the Yeshiva. I have been here for the past 3 years. And two things that I would say that I love about the Yeshiva are the Rebbeim. There's one for every single kid there, and just the Chevra. Just everybody can feel like they belong, and there's just great, great kids here. Thank you, Rabbi.
Thank you, Itai. And Yaakov Avner, great to have you. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Thank you, Rabbi. My name is Yaakov Avner. I'm from Northbrook, Illinois. I went to Ari Crown Hebrew Day School, and I'm only in ninth grade, so I've only been here for almost half a year. But already I hear from other students, and I can see myself that the atmosphere and the support that the Yeshiva offers in Limudei Kodesh, Limudei Chol, and even outside the Yeshiva with the extra resources that they give their students, it's really nice. It's a great experience.
Yaakov, continued Hatzlacha. You're doing beautifully. Great to have you. Thank you so much. And a perspective, I know you've heard from a few dormers, but we do have another student who would like to tell you a little bit about the dormitory, Solomon Dobin. Solomon Dobin, who is also a co-president of the student body. Here we go. There's Solomon. Great to see you.
Thank you, Rabbi Kupchik. My name is Solomon Dobin. I've been a dormer here for 4 years. I'm from Houston, Texas. I just want to tell you my favorite parts about the Yeshiva, and I think there are clear benefits of dorming at the Yeshiva compared to other places you may be considering. First thing you might see in the background, we have beautiful renovated dorm rooms. Usually there are two people in a dorm room per year. This year we have one because of COVID, but roommate usually always pair you with a good guy. You really get to develop a great relationship with them. Yeshiva always at night, after school, after Zoom, whatever you need, they always have something to do for you. You have a workout room that was also recently just renovated, great equipment, great to use, great hours. We also have Hill Torah gym across the street if you want to play basketball. We have a track right by Fairview. If you ever need food from the supermarket or clothes, we have a massive shopping mall across the street. We have Jewelosco, we have Walmart, stuff like that. Aside from dinner, we have Mr. Kleiman, who's the head dorm supervisor. He always supplies us with a home cooked meal, whether it's sometimes steak or chicken or chicken wings. It's also all really, really good. For Shabbos, we have great Shabbos. We have onegs. Usually a Rebbe comes in from Chicago, from West Hartford Park, comes in, spend Shabbos with us. We have ruach singing, all really fun. In a regular year, we usually get to go to our friend's house. We usually have an out Shabbos. And I think the best part about that is how welcoming and warm the Chicago community is and welcoming us into their community. And that's really all.
Amazing, amazing. Thank you so much, Solomon. A significant part of our Yeshiva, as mentioned earlier in this evening's program, is the extracurricular and co-curricular activities, which tremendously enhance the overall education. Gives me great honor at this time to introduce to you Rabbi Daniel Cantor, assistant to the principal, who's going to tell you a little bit about all those opportunities.
Shalom Aleichem, everybody. Good evening. Thank you all so much for coming and joining us. As several of us have already noted, the extracurriculars at the Yeshiva is something that truly sets us apart. It's really outstanding. The main goal, I believe, is for the extracurriculars is for us to be able to continue to develop that positive social emotional environment that's so crucial to teens and to young adults in building them and having them grow from elementary school to yeshiva and college or base medrash and beyond. We have many, many varied, a large different variety of extracurricular activities to focus on whatever every individual might need. So we have Torah, extracurriculars, we have sports, trips, Shabbatonim, social, chesed, just to highlight a few of them briefly. In regards to our Torah programming, we have a chabura almost every single night that's offered that guys take the initiative to go and learn. We have, for example, this past year, we had our Maseches Kedushin chabura, where over 30 guys signed up on their own accord and committed to finishing Maseches Kedushin by the end of the year. And these are guys that are not learning because they have to. They're learning at 8:30, 9:30, 10 o'clock because they want to, because that's the initiative that they do. And we do our best to empower them to get that learning in. We also have our latest hit is Kiyem Chayenu, our Torah newsletter. Here's just one copy that you can see throughout all the shuls, the chance for the Talmidim to write Divrei Torah and have them be published throughout the community so that people can see the Divrei Torah and see what they learn. In regards to sports, we have a basketball team, we have a baseball team. Depending on the season, we have intramural football, baseball, basketball. We have a chess tournament even. COVID sometimes makes some of these challenging, but despite that, we still do everything that we can to enable the students to have a socially appropriate environment while still remaining COVID safe. In regards to trips on the average year, we have, in addition to our kickoff trip, every shir has their own trip, just to get that chance, to get that avira, that atmosphere, that connection, to inspire them. The Rebbeim usually go on the trips with the guys to facilitate that, to develop that connection. And on a similar note, we also have Shabbatonim and Onegs almost every single week, whether it be the dormers going to the in-towners to visit their friends, or the in-towners coming to the yeshiva to spend a Shabbos here at the Rebbeim's houses, away on a resort. A few weeks ago, we went to the Doubletree in Arlington Heights with the dorm in our individual unique pod model that enables us to do so in the COVID environment, just to have the guys get away and to have the dormers feel like if this is their home away from home, which in truth it really is. On a similar note, just specifically in the dorm, Solomon highlighted some of these briefly, but we make every attempt, even in COVID, to try to go on trips with the dormers whenever we can to, in this year, in COVID safe environments, but in general, whether it be bowling on Motzei Shabbos or ice skating or swimming or mini golfing, whatever it may be, just to give the dormers that atmosphere of love and care and connection. And often the dorm counselors who are our base medrash guys that live on campus and that connect with the dormers, often they go on the trips as well to just build that connection, that kesher, that is so valuable to students at this age in their lives. And God willing, we'll see your son and be able to impact him positively and have that base medrash and these rabbeim and our extracurricular programs and have that positive hashpa on him as well. I'm looking forward to seeing your son here.
Thank you so much, Rabbi Cantor. Wow, this yeshiva sounds remarkable. I wish my own son could be here. You know what? He is. Baruch Hashem. I had a son who graduated this yeshiva. I have a son who's a current senior. It is a tremendous place. Baruch Hashem, I could speak as a parent as well. At this time, I want to introduce to you, in case you don't know him yet, Rabbi Josh Zisuk, who coordinates our admissions process, does so much for the yeshiva on so many different fronts, who will talk a little bit about the application process and give anyone an opportunity, if you want to post a question, that we'll try to address if we haven't already addressed it yet. This time, Rabbi Zisuk, if you could figure out the technology and unmute yourself. Thank you. Nope, not yet. I think you're manning a few computers, so
just... Okay, can you hear me now? You can hear me now? Awesome. Okay, it's a pleasure to see everybody on the this virtual open house. I have to say, to see so many people from near and far, from local Chicago, from across the country, from Canada, totally amazing. You have made my job much easier because normally I'm on a plane trying to meet you in your locale, and today I can meet you from my office, but more than that, I hope to be able to meet you and take you on a virtual tour at some point be happy to take you through the day, and that'd be my great pleasure to do so. Just some of the admissions components that we have coming down the pipeline. Number one, if you're a student here in Chicago, we're offering the ACT Explore test. That's coming up at the end of December. So keep in mind that will be taking place then. And we will be sending out more information about that test. So you don't need to worry about that right now. We will send that to you. If you've not been getting our emails, My email is in the chat. Please send me an email. I want to make sure you are getting the emails. And it's not because I neglected to send it to you, but it's because I didn't have it or there's some issue. So I want to make sure to get it to you. We're going to have a makeup test. Now, beginning of January, our online application portal will be opening. You may ask, I want to apply tomorrow. And the answer is, I would love for you to apply to tomorrow. However, we are going to an online portal. The online portal was supposed to be done a month ago, but has been delayed because of COVID. And we hope to have that open very soon. And it's slated to be open on January 4th. Hopefully it should make things easier for the applicants, for the families to apply to the Yeshiva. Finally, after you apply to the Yeshiva, we will have bechinas and interviews. We will schedule those. We have basically the month of February blocked off for bechinas and interviews. We will coordinate with me, coordinate with Rabbi Kupchik, and we will do that on Zoom, unfortunately. And we wait the day when we can have you in person, every student here in person. If I could throw in another commercial, and then I'm gonna let everybody go because we are over time. But the commercial is that I was a dormer here many years ago from Seattle, Washington, and I am still here. And it's because of this amazing yeshiva. It's not because I got in trouble, it's because I came back here willingly. And I came here because it had everything that I was looking for and a well-balanced yeshiva, both Limudei Kodesh, general studies, so many programs, although different programs back in the day. And I often wish I was in school today because there are more programs now than there were. And just an amazing thing for you, if you're a student watching, for your sons, I highly encourage you to take a look at it, ask the right questions, talk to other parents, and feel free to reach out to us. And you know, that's really the main thing, learn as much as you can about the Yeshiva. So thank you all for tuning in. At this point, I'm turning it back to Rabbi Kupchik. If there are any questions that we can address, you know, please feel free to put it into the chat right now. We'll take a few more minutes. We know the hour is late, and we thank everybody for attending.
Yes, thank you, thank you, thank you is right. We have answered some of the questions on the chat. And I think what we take pride in is our customer service. So we want you to feel comfortable to reaching out to us when questions pop into your head or you think of them over the next day, week, month. You'll be hearing from us, as Rabbi Zizek said, about how to continue this application process, how to learn more about the yeshiva. We're just so excited by so much of what we do here and so much that's yet to come.
So Rabbi Kupchik.
Yeah.
So a question that was asked was, do we hope to have secular studies in person next year, regardless of COVID?
I responded already on the chat.
Oh, you did? Okay. Sorry.
We beat you to it. I'm happy to just repeat my answer that we are seriously looking into rolling out general studies in person immediately after winter break in some form. We see the benefits of it. We're doing great on Zoom, and we haven't missed a beat and missed a day, but at the same time, we know that it's still much better in person, so we're looking to roll that out. And God willing, this virus will be, behind us, and for sure, be able to have full program and full in-person classes next year. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Great. So we're going to allow you to go at this point. Thank you for joining us, and looking forward to meeting you in person at the right time. Okay. We're going to end with a little bit of. Musical ending. Thank you. We'll be right back. Shikoach, everyone. We're signing off.